Is climate change real? In 2021, scorching temperatures triggered wildfires in Siberia and Greece, and deadly heat waves in Pakistan and Canada. Meanwhile, both China and Germany suffered heavy flooding. A particularly severe and persistent drought in Madagascar has brought 1 million people to the verge of what is being referred to as the world's first climate change-induced famine. From the North to the South Pole, the globe is warming. The average global surface temperature is estimated to have increased by more than 1.6 degrees Fahrenheit since 1906. In the delicate polar regions, the increase is notably high. Since the pre-industrial period, human activities have had an impact on global temperature. But those who deny global warming disagree. They view climate change as a natural process. Therefore, there is no reason for us to be worried. In fact, they think that humans have nothing to do with climate change. Some deniers argue that the consequences of climate change won't be so bad. Life will still go on. The best approach for this is to wait and see how events unfold naturally. Meanwhile, some argue that the crisis is a hoax created by the scientific community to secure funding for their research, or even a conspiracy by governments to control the public. Climate deniers further argue that since many people have invested in the renewable energy sector, they stand to lose a lot of money if global warming is proven to be a myth. This idea holds that in order to protect their financial investment in green energy, those investors have bribed climate scientists to misrepresent their results. However, tens of thousands of published, peer-reviewed research have formed a strong scientific consensus that human activities have an effect on climate change. The repercussions of rising temperatures are already visible. They are not something that will happen in the far future. As a result of global warming, precipitation patterns are being disturbed, glaciers and sea ice are melting, and animals are migrating. Shifts in temperatures and weather patterns over a long period of time are referred to as climate change. These changes sometimes occur naturally. For instance, through variations in the solar radiation, orbital changes, emissions from volcanoes, etc. However, since the 1800s, human activities have been the primary cause of climate change. Those activities include burning of fossil fuels like coal, oil, and gas. The terms climate change and global warming are often used interchangeably. However, climate change does not necessarily cause temperatures to rise. In some places, it actually causes a temporary drop in temperature. Therefore, instead of global warming, Scientists prefer to use the term climate change to describe the complex shifts now affecting our planet's weather and climate systems. Fossil fuel burning produces greenhouse gases that serve as a blanket around the Earth, trapping solar heat and increasing temperatures. Carbon dioxide and methane are two examples of greenhouse gases that are contributing to climate change. Deforestation is another contributor to carbon dioxide emissions. On the other hand, landfills are the main source of methane emissions. The other major emitters are energy industry, transport, buildings, agriculture, and land use. Emissions keep increasing. As a result, the Earth is estimated to be 1.1 degrees Celsius warmer today than it was in the late 1800s. The most recent 10 years are regarded as the warmest on record. Based on various research done over the years, the following are found to be some of the impacts of climate change. Globally, and particularly at the Earth's poles, ice is melting. This includes Arctic sea ice sheets spanning over West Antarctica, and mountain glaciers. For instance, the number of glaciers in Montana's Glacier National Park is estimated to have dropped from more than 150 in 1910 to less than 30 as of 2020. Since glaciers store around 75% of the world's freshwater, melting glaciers will eventually deplete the world's freshwater reserve. The rise in sea level is largely a result of ice melting. Global sea levels are rising at the rate of 3.2 millimeters per year. In recent years, the rise has accelerated and is expected to increase even more in the decades to come. Consequently, by the end of the century, sea levels are predicted to increase by 26 to 82 centimeters, or maybe even more. Wildlife and their habitats are being impacted by warming temperatures. Rapidly melting ice has posed a threat to some species. A daily penguin populations in Antarctica have decreased by 90% as a result of glacier melting. Globally, there has been an increase in rain and snowfall, while certain areas are suffering from more severe droughts. Droughts raise the risk of wildfires, destroyed crops, and shortages of drinking water, while high rainfall increases the risk of flooding. Climate change will increase the likelihood of stronger hurricanes and other storms. Droughts and floods will occur more frequently. By 2100, large portions of the United States are expected to be more susceptible to mega droughts, which last for many decades. As a result, some species, such as crop pests, ticks, jellyfish, and mosquitoes, will thrive. Some infections, like malaria transmitted by mosquitoes, will be common, especially in tropical countries. What can we do to protect our planet from this? The three primary categories of action include reducing emissions, preparing for the effects of climate change, and supporting essential adaptations. Let's have a look at reducing emissions. By switching from fossil fuels to renewable energy sources, like solar, hydropower, or wind, we'll decrease carbon emissions. But we must get started early. While a growing number of nations have pledged to achieve net zero emissions by 2050, it is necessary to achieve around half of those reductions by 2030, in order to prevent global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius or less. This requires 6% annual drop in the burning of fossil fuels between the years 2020 and 2030. Second of all, how we can be prepared for the effect. Adapting to the effects of climate change includes protecting people, homes, businesses, livelihoods, infrastructure, and natural ecosystems. Both the immediate and likely long-term effects should be reviewed. While adaptation is necessary everywhere, priority should be given to the most vulnerable populations, who have the fewest means to deal with climate risks. The rate of return of the early preparation can be substantial. For example, benefits of disaster early warning systems can be up to 10 times of the initial investment. Shifting to greener energies and prepare for the repercussions appears to be a great idea. But what about the funding? Governments and corporations must invest money to combat the global climate crisis. This is crucial, since ignoring climate change has been shown to be far more expensive. Wealthy nations must fulfill their commitments by offering financial support to developing countries. This is essential to facilitate their transition to greener economies. Simple rhetoric or empty pledges from wealthy nations will not stop climate change. Since we are largely responsible for climate change, we must work together to mitigate its repercussions. Thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing, liking, and sharing, which means a lot to me. I love to see your thoughts in the comment section.